Hey guys, welcome back to this SQL tutorial course. In this session, we will learn exception handling in SQL. So an error condition during a program execution is called as an exception. And the mechanism for resolving such an exception is known as exception handling. And we can do exception handling in SQL with the help of try-catch blocks. So the try statement allows us to test a block of statements while they're being executed. And the catch block allows us to handle any exception which occurs in the try block. Now let's have a look at the syntax of the try catch block. So we'll give the keywords begin, try, and then give the statements which are to be tested. After that, we'll end the try block and begin the catch block. And inside the catch block, we'll either print the error or roll back the transaction. And we'll end the catch block as well. So let's go to SQL Server and do some exception handling. So I'll be declaring two variables and divide one of the variables with zero. So this needs to give us divided by zero exception. So let's go ahead and handle this exception now. So we can declare a variable in SQL by using the declare statement. So I'll type declare and then use the @ symbol to declare a value. And I'll name this variable as val1, and this is of integer type. Similarly, let me go ahead and declare the second variable. I'll type declare @, and the name of this variable is val2, and the data type is integer again. Now I'll begin the try block. I'll type begin try. And then inside this, I will set the values for both value1 and value2. So I'll use the set keyword. And then the value which I'll be assigning to val1 is 8. I'll put semicolon. Similarly, let me assign something to val2 as well. So set @ val2. Now inside val2, what I'll basically do is divide val1 with 0. So now this statement should basically give us the error. So when we divide any integer value with a zero, we'll get an indefinite value. So this is the statement which will be giving the error. Now I will end the try block and try. Right. Now after this, we'll begin the catch block. Begin, catch, and inside the catch block, I will just print out the error which occurred in the try block. And I will display the default error message. And I will end the catch block as well. So let me hit execute now. So the default error message which you get is divide by zero error encountered. So what we basically did with the set of statements was we encountered an error within the try block and we handled that error inside the catch block. So inside the catch block, we sent a default error message, and that default error message was divide by zero error encountered. Now we can also create user defined messages. So let's go ahead and create some user defined messages. And for that purpose, I'll be doing exception handling on top of the employee table. So let me actually have a glance at the employee table first. Select star from, the name of the table is employee. Right, so we have this employee table right in front of us. So now what I'll do is I'll try to add the salary column and the name column. Now the problem with this is, we cannot add a numerical column with a string value. So let's handle this exception. So I'll type begin try, and then I will give the select keyword, and I will try to add e salary column with the e name column. And I want this from the employee table. I will end the try block. After this, I need to begin the catch block. So begin catch. Now inside this, I will print a user defined message. So print, and I would want to print cannot add a numerical value with a string value. I will end the catch block as well. After this, I will give the go statement. Let me hit execute. So this is the message which we get. Cannot add a numerical value with a string value. And we got this user defined message because we had encountered an error inside the try block. So this is how we can do exception handling in SQL. Thanks for attending the session. Let's meet in the next class.